No, where is that thing? I think it's got... Oh, no, that's not it either. No, that's not it either. Let's see. What have we got? Oh, hey there. I thought you might be here. I'm sorry about the noise. I'm trying to find my special baking pan so I can bake Mrs. Henry an angel food cake. She loves angel food. But don't tell anybody. It's a surprise. Maybe it's this one. Nah, it's that one. Okay, maybe it's this one. Nah, it's not that one either.
Are you all right, Mr. Henry?
Yes, dear. I'm just fine. Eureka! Here it is! Voila! My special heart-shaped pan would bake the perfect cake for my very special lady. Now it is time for the chef to begin. I think I have a problem. Yes, Arn. I'm sure I got a problem now. I need some help getting this thing off.
I can't really tell.
Well, I've got the cake in the oven, and I think it's almost done, but I can't tell. I installed an oven timer program in Circuitous, but I forgot to set it. And now I'm still stuck wearing my banana bread pan on my foot. If I could just see the cake, I could probably tell if it's done. But my experimental oven light's burned out and I can't see a thing in there. If I just crack the door open just a little bit, I could peek inside.
Hello? Delivery guy?
You just about sent me through the ceiling.
Sorry about that. Okay, what's going on?
I had a little baking accident.
All right, then.
Can you help me get this thing off?
Sure. All in the line of duty.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe, have a seat.
Yeah, just kind of yank at it or something.
All there. Right.
Ready?
Yeah.
On
three.
Three,
okay, yeah, okay.
Ready?
All right.
One, two.
Okay.
I don't think that did it.
Any suggestions?
If I had that super duper, that magnet thing that
I ordered. You mean the super deluxe magno puller?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, the super deluxe magno puller. I was just like.
Voila.
Well, what do you know?
Yeah.
They said it was going to take 6 to 8 weeks to get this thing.
I decided to bring it over early.
Oh. Well, here.
Okay.
You take it.
Okay.
Now we're gonna try it out. Now I'm gonna.
All right.
Okay. Now I'm gonna sit here, and you just went on three. We'll turn it on. Gonna get myself. Okay. All right.
Uh-huh.
One, two. Three!
Hey! Hey, are you okay?
Hey, I'm just fine!
Shoot!
All right!
Worked pretty well!
Yeah!
Danger! Danger, Mr. Henry! Danger!
Oh! I'm sure glad I put a clear and present danger detector in Circuitous last week.
Is everything still okay, Mr. Henry?
Yes, dear. Yeah, oh, yeah, everything's under control. We're fine. I'm fine. He's fine. We're fine.
I'm getting out of here. Here, sign for this so I can go.
Oh, okay. Well, where am I supposed to sign?
No, just sign here.
All right.
Ow. Thanks. Well, I'll see you.
All right, I'll see you. Okay. Ow! Just what I always needed. It's a new light bulb for the oven. I didn't order a bulb for the oven.
Well, actually, it's not. That's a tropical plant growing bulb.
Oh.
You see, ovens come with a 25-watt standard bulb that you can usually use.
I was trying to grow tropical plants in the oven. I was trying to replicate their natural habitat.
Is that what was on fire?
No. That's a cake I was trying to bake for my dear wife. I was going to put a grow bulb in the oven because maybe that would help me to bake bigger and better bread and cakes, and it didn't work.
Okay. Well, I guess somebody knew you needed it and ordered it for you.
Really?
Yeah, I guess you might say it's a gift.
That's kind of awesome. I wonder who gave it to me.
Yeah, I guess somebody that knows you pretty well.
I guess you're right. That was awfully nice of them to do that.
It was.
Yeah.
Hey, I do have to go. You know what? All this gift giving's kind of gotten me inspired. You don't know of a good little gift shop around town, do you?
Yeah, I know one on 4th and Lindley.
You know, I want to get something for my mom and dad.
Oh, yeah,
and my
aerobics
instructor.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
And my yodeling coach.
Oh, every yodeling coach needs one.
Yeah, and I'd like to get something maybe for my...
Yeah.
How very kind of someone to notice that Mr. Henry needed a special light bulb.
Yeah, and paying for it, too. That's good stuff.
And a very generous and noble thing indeed.
I'd do something like that for any of you boys, if I could.
Ah, thanks, Miss Harriet. And I'd share my fish food with you, if I could.
Well done. You are a true gentle fish, Bubbles. That was a beautiful thought.
Oui, oui, très bien, Monsieur Bubbles. There is a lot of love in this room right now. I feel it in my gills.
Oh, I'm tearing up here. I'm about to flood my fish bowl.
Who wants a hug?
That delivery guy sure is excited about giving things to people. You know, I love being a giver. How about you? Feels great inside. I know someone that gave and gave, and he did it in lots of ways. Let's take a look.
Toward the beginning of his ministry, Jesus was walking by the Sea of Galilee, and he saw two brothers, Peter and Andrew, fishing. He said to them, "Come, follow me. I'll make you fishers of men." Peter and Andrew dropped their nets in the lake and they followed Jesus. Jesus said the same thing to James and John, and they did. Jesus gathered 12 men to follow him. They left their jobs, their homes, without question. One day, Jesus and his followers were heading toward Jerusalem. The people of Jerusalem had always been told a king was coming and that he'd come into town riding on a baby donkey. Jesus told two of his followers, "Go into town. You'll find a colt tied there. Bring it to me. If anyone asks you why you're taking it, say, 'The master needs it.'" As soon as they got into town, they saw the colt and they started to untie it.
Hey! What are you doing with my colt?
The master needs it.
Oh, why didn't you say so? If the master needs it, no problem. I wonder who the master is.
Ah, now that was a good question. People didn't really know yet. In fact, a while back, Jesus had a little chat with his followers about this. Who do people say I am? Well, some people say John the Baptist. And who do you say I am? You are the Messiah, the Son of God. You're right, Peter, you're right. But don't tell anyone yet. It isn't time. But all of you need to know something. The Son of Man must suffer many things. He will be rejected by the older Jewish leaders, the priests, and the teachers of the law. And the Son of Man will be killed.
Killed?
Master! Master, we don't want you to be killed. After 3 days, the Son of Man will be raised from the dead. If you want to follow me, you must be willing to even die on a cross.
I want to follow you,
yes,
Jesus.
Yeah,
I want to follow you too.
So they followed him. Jesus rode to Jerusalem on the colt. As soon as the people in town saw Jesus coming, they celebrated. This crowd totally misunderstood who Jesus was. He wasn't there to overthrow Rome. He was there to overthrow sin. They may have cheered for him when he got there, but Jesus knew as soon as they realized he wasn't there to help overthrow Rome, they'd turn against him. When Jesus went into their temple, he saw people using it as a building to make money. They were selling things inside. Well, Jesus was concerned with prayer and worship and not money. And he made all the money changers and the salesmen in the temple stop. Now, the high priests and the leaders, they didn't like that one bit.
Now, those leaders, they just didn't like Jesus one bit. But that didn't keep Jesus from loving them and giving his time and his attention and his love to anyone that would listen. He didn't think of himself. He just wanted to help people get close to God. Here, I'm going to show you how. Now, let's just say that this mountain right here, this is God's mountain. God's mountain. He lives on it. He has a great view. The air is clean and fresh. And he can yodel. But he's alone, okay? All right? Now, let's say that this mountain over here, well, this is your mountain. You're living here all by yourself. And God, who created you, and he's your dad in heaven, he wanted you to live on his mountain. But no, you wanted to do things your own way and not obey his rules. So now, you've got your own mountain, and he's got his mountain. Well, you've got fresh air, yeah. You can yodel, you can have a good time, but things just don't seem right inside, because you're supposed to be God with God on his mountain, but you can't go over to be with God on his mountain because you and everyone else doesn't want to do things the way God wants you to do it. You're doing things that God doesn't like.
Extreme sadness. Bummer. Bummer.
Well, fortunately for you and me, God decided to give us a very cool present. It's a piece of car track.
Hip, hip, hooray. Hip, hip, hooray.
Okay. I know. You're wondering what's so cool about a piece of car track. Well, okay. It's not really a car track. It's Jesus. What? You're more confused? You think I've gotten nutty or lost my marbles? Well, actually, I found some marbles. I got them right here. Right here in my pocket, see? And they're going to help me out. Now, come on back down here again. Okay, now I'm sure you know that Jesus isn't really a car track, but you know, God did give Jesus as a gift to you and me. You just watch this. Now this is you over here on your mountain, and you're yodeling and you're having fun, but you're missing God, because he made you to be with him, and you feel like a puzzle with a piece missing right here in the center. That piece is God himself, and this is God over here. He's missing you big time. So God gives you Jesus as a present. His plan was to have Jesus lay down his life, and Jesus followed God's plan and did just that. Like this, see? Jesus became a bridge between you and me over here. God over here. Now we can use Jesus to come over and be with God, you know? Enjoy the view, yodel, enjoy being with God forever. Everyone needs what Jesus was giving. God sent Jesus into the world as a gift. God knew that everyone everywhere was going to sin, you know, do things that he doesn't like. So he made a plan to fix the problem.
It's time to rattle your thinking cap with a round of nuts and bolts. Yeah, see if you can come up with the answer before I spell it out for you. Okay, here's the question. Earlier, Mr. Henry showed us that Jesus is like a what between us and God. Can you figure it out? Here's a quick clue. The way over water is a boat or a... The answer's a bridge. Yeah, did I shake you up or did you nail the answer? Yeah, well, either way, thanks for playing Nuts and Bolts.
Oh, dear. It's a mess in there. And my heart-shaped baking pan, along with its contents, is completely ruined. Ruined! Oh, well. I guess there's no point in crying over burnt cake.
Attention, Mr. Henry. Attention, Mr. Henry.
What is it?
Themalator. Themalator.
Oh, the themalator. That's right. We need the theme for today. Okay, yeah. Use this. All right. Yeah, I can do this. Okay. Oh, let's put this thing to use. All right. Oh, man. Whoa. He's working pretty hard. I'm gonna be prepared this time. Wow! That was one hot potato. Hey, look at that. It's a heart-shaped pan that I ruined. And look, it's got a note inside. It says, salvation. It has one of those barcodes inside. Hey, I've got something to read this. Let's go. All right. Here we go. It says paid in full. Hey, that's just like the light bulb I got today. This is a gift, too. It's free. Oh, yeah. John 3:16. This is all starting to make sense. Have you figured it out? Come on, let's head over to the Scroll-O-Matic 3000. John 3:16, baby! There it is. For God so loved the world. That's everybody. No matter if you're a real sweet grandma or a mean kid on the school bus, God loves us so much that he gave his only son. And the Bible says, if we believe that Jesus is the Son of God and we ask him to come and be inside our hearts, we'll be with him forever. That's called salvation. And that's the word the themalator threw out at me, along with a new heart-shaped baking pan, which I'm gonna use right now.
Something smells fantastic.
I think it's Mr. Henry's special heart-shaped cake.
Yeah, it might smell good, but I bet you it doesn't taste half as good as my fishy flakes.
I don't know how to tell you this, everyone. I should warn you that is to say...
Come on, out with it, pal.
Well, yes, as I was about to say...
Five.
Oh, dear.
Four. This can't be good.
Three.
What is it this time?
Two.
Close your eyes. Oh, wait, we can't.
One.
Hang on to your fish tank.
The cake is done.
Heh, is that all? That's not...
That's my new oven timer. That means the cake's done. That smells so good. That makes me want to play a song. Okay, I call this my cake bacon bluegrass boogie.
Thank you. Good day, friends. How would you like your words? Scrambled, I hope. It's time for a little mixed-up fun. Now, I've cooked up a little word puzzle for you. I'll give you some clues, and you try to solve the puzzle before the egg timer sounds. Right, let's begin. Visitunnel? No, Maya, that's not right. You get this through God's only son. Tilasavan. I think we still have some work to do here. Last clue. It lasts forever. I'm afraid your time is up. The word is salvation. It's the wonderful gift God has waiting to give us if we believe Jesus died for us. Did you solve the puzzle? Fantastic. Thank you for playing my game. Ta!
Oh, hi there! I'm about to put the trimmings on this baby. I've modified the inoculator so it'll serve as an automatic cake froster. All I have to do is this, and this, and then this little modification here. And I'm ready to frost my cake. That is, if I had an automatic cake froster frosting to put in there.
Ding dong, ding dong. Hello, hello.
Yeah, you guessed it. I put a doorbell chip in the circuitous. What do you think? Pretty cool, huh?
Ding-a-ling, ding-a-ling.
Hey! Special delivery for Mr. Henry.
For me?
Yeah, and you don't even have to sign for this one because it's a little gift from me to you.
Oh, that is so sweet. Oh, you shouldn't have done this.
Yeah, it's just a little cake frosting pack. You can use it in your automatic cake froster.
Well, how did you...
I saw the machine last time I was here. I thought you might need it.
That's just what I needed. Yeah. That is really sweet of you. Thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome very much.
Yeah, I'll see you around.
Okay. Probably not too soon,
though. Oh, what?
Yeah, I got a lot of other gifts to deliver, too.
All
yeah,
right.
I got this from a brother. Kind of excited about it.
Oh, it's Darwin.
He's the plumber guy.
Yeah, I love the color.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
Great.
And
yeah,
I got a little pen and pencil set for my little nephews. They're little student guys.
Hey, keep them in the books and stuff.
That's
yeah,
right. That's what I'm
thinking.
All right.
Good thinking.
Okay.
Good stuff. Yeah, well, see you around.
All right, see ya.
Okay, see ya.
Okay. All right, see ya. Bye-bye.
Bye. Well... Let's go load up the cake froster. Hey, what do you think? Pretty cool, huh? I can't wait to surprise my dear sweet wife.
Professor Henry calling Mr. Henry. Are you there?
Oh, hi, Professor Henry. I can see you just fine.
Splendid, brother. Say, I thought that I might chime in with a thought.
Well, sure, go ahead, Professor Henry.
Well, it seems that you have discussed the concept of getting or receiving a gift.
Yeah.
Well, since your theme today is salvation, I thought it might be useful to introduce a story or two about losing something valuable that belongs to you and then recovering it again.
Sure, I think I follow you. It sounds like a great idea.
Well, then with your permission.
Sure, yeah, go ahead.
I'm here to share a tale. Well, actually a parable. Well, actually two parables about two lost things. We call it the tale, or parable, or two parables, whatever, about two lost things from the bestseller, The Bible, from the book of Luke, chapter 15. It wasn't the worst of times. It wasn't the best of times. It was ancient times. There was a lady who had 10 silver coins that she enjoyed very much.
You know, I sure am enjoying these coins. They mean so much to me. Well, I have money to shop with. I can buy myself a new tunic, maybe some grapes. Maybe I could put some in savings.
Meanwhile, perhaps at the same time, or sooner or later, I really don't know, there was a man who really enjoyed his flock of 100 sheep.
Man, I sure do like looking after these sheep. They're awesome. Let's see, 39, 40, 41. Oh, I already counted him.
Yes, well, it doesn't say exactly what happened, but the man, I don't know, maybe he,
91, 92. I'm starting to feel a little.
And maybe, meanwhile, perhaps at the same time, or sooner or later, I really don't know.
6, 7, 8. No, wait. I already ate. Or did I? Whatever.
Okay, so I don't know how it happened, but the man, he lost 100 sheep.
Yes, sir, you're right. You seem to be missing, one sheep.
And the lady? Lost one of her 10 silver coins.
Yes, coin lady, I'm getting the same count. We have lost one coin.
Yes. Well, to wrap it up with a happy ending. I said happy ending. Thank you. The sheep man left his 99 sheep and, after a search made brief for lack of time, found his precious lost sheep. And maybe, meanwhile, perhaps at the same time, or sooner or later, I really don't know, the coin lady, after a thorough house cleaning and a search with a lamp, both made brief for lack of time, found her precious coin.
Oh, I found it.
It says in both parables that the sheep man and the coin lady both called their friends up to celebrate finding their lost things. Maybe they were friends.
Hello, coin lady.
Sheep man, how are you?
I'm great. You know, I lost one of those 100 sheep that I love so much, and I just couldn't bear the thought of being without one of them, even though I had 99 others. Well, I searched everywhere, and I found him. Woohoo!
Well, you know, I was about to call you. I lost one of my 10 coins. Sure, I had 9, but I wasn't gonna be happy until I had all 10 together. I turned my house upside down, and by golly, I found it.
That's awesome. Why don't you come over to my field and we'll celebrate together?
Well, that sounds great. I'll bring our mutual friend, the accountant, Woo-hoo. And something to drink.
Brother, are you sure they had cell phones? I don't think the Middle East had service yet. You know, back in biblical times.
Oh, well. Yeah. You're quite right, brother. An oversight, I'm sure. All right, then. We're going to lose the phones. Well, then, let's proceed, shall we?
Yes, well, the coin lady and the sheep guy called their friends together to celebrate. Is that they were both very happy to have found the things that they lost.
Well, there you have it. Another exemplary performance of the parabolic teaching, or two, to be precise.
Oh, it was wonderful, brother. Thanks a lot for the help. They really showed how God isn't happy having almost everyone with him in heaven forever. He wants everyone there. We're all precious to him.
Precisely, Mr. Henry. Well, I'll be in touch. For now, ta-ta.
Bye.
It's time to test your noggin. Can you stand the pressure? Can you take the heat? It's time to put you on the hot seat.
First question. According to the story Mr. Henry told, Jesus became a bridge between A, the young and old, B, the mountains and the valleys, or C, God and people. Think quick. Got your answer? It's C. Jesus became a bridge between God and people. He made a way for us to be together with God. Next question. Fill in this blank from John 3:16. For God loved the world so much that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him may have what? Is the answer A, eternal life? B, a big vacation? Or C, lots of presents? The answer is A, eternal life. Final question. The stories of the lost coins and lost sheep remind us that A, God loves money and animals. B, God wants everyone to be with him in heaven. Or C, God has special angels that look for lost things. And the answer is B, God wants everyone to be with him in heaven. That's it for now. Keep you cool till your next shot at the hot seat.
Well, I don't know if my experimental oven light helped make my cake any bigger than usual or anything, but at least I can see inside my oven again. You know, all of us have done wrong. So all of us have sin in our hearts. We're dark inside, just like the oven. And our hearts really want God's love inside. So if we open up our hearts like this, and we ask Jesus to come on in, if we believe in our heart that he died on the cross for each of us, well, then he comes in, and he fills in all that dark, empty space in our hearts with his love. It's a great feeling to be close to God. It makes life better, and people can tell you've changed. You sort of, you shine out just like the light bulb in this oven. It lights up everything inside, shines right out through the glass window in the oven door. Believe in Jesus. Ask him to come into your life. He'll do it. God gave us his son, Jesus. Just like I'm gonna give this cake to my wonderful wife. I'll see you later.
I'm here to help.
Brush and floss every day.
I'm here to make this shoot the best it can be.
My lip hurts.
I'm a team player.
I am on the wrong page.
You know what you've come up with? Would anyone be available back there to get me a bottle of water? Of my super wacky foam balls, just to give you some idea of what that must be like. I wonder if this is gonna be a very good idea. We're moving on up to the east side. Hello? Is anybody down there? And here's the letter.
Okay, then.
All right, and it's moving.
Now, I didn't drop them that time.
No.
Are you happy? Okay.
If we go bam, have them do that, we won't want to.
Hey. Yeah. Well, hush my mouth.
Ah, I'm glad he liked it. Good boy.
Let's do it over again. Just run back. Then, look, this happened when I was waiting by.
Stop. Let's get it. Try to see you, man. Now, great. You can do 30 moves. See? Let's do it again. Do it again.
Okay.
I'm with you. Would you say, okay, we go.
Right.